Hello everyone, welcome to the channel. So today's topic is tech number, and we will see what is the tech number, logic behind, and the program written in Java. So let's start with the video. So this definition I have written over here, but with the help of example I want to tell what is that exactly. So let's take an example of a number and we will find whether that number is tech number or not. So let's suppose I have taken a number 2025. So first line, what they are saying that a number which has an even number of digits, that means the number of digits should be even. That means if we count the number of digits of a number, so this is first, second, three, four. That means in this number there are four digits. That means it is even. So a number which has even number of digits. Second condition is when the number of digits split into two halves. After finding that number is even, the number is having even number of digits, after that what we will do, we will split the number in two halves. That means 20 is your first half, 25 is your second half. What third line is saying, then the square of the sum of two halves. That means we have two halves, this is first half and this is your second half. When we take sum, that means 20 plus 25. What is that? 45. Square of the sum of two halves. That means sum of two halves we got 45. And square of this. That means 45 square. So 45 square is 45 multiply 45. What it will give you? It will give you 2025. That means if we got again original number 2025 and we started with the number 2025, if both numbers are same, that means 2025 is your tech number. Okay, let's see with the help of one more example. Let's take 81. So number of digits are 2, that means even number of digits. Second, when we have to split it into two halves, that means 8 plus 1. So what is the sum of two halves? 8 plus 1, that is 9. So if we take square of this sum will be 9 is to power 2, that is your 9 multiply 9, that is your 81. If this number equals to your original number, that means that number is your tech number. So let's see, this is what the logic behind tech number. Let's see how we will write the program of tech number. So here you can see what we will do. First we will take a number from the user, then we will find the number of digits. If it's even, then we will go further. If it's not even, the number of digits. If it is not even, then it is not a tech number. Okay. So if the number of digits is not even, then the number is not tech number. Next, calculate the first half and the second half. We have to split the number into two half, first half and second half. Then we will take the sum of both halves. Then we will do the sum of both halves, like what we did, 20 plus 25, if our number was 2025, so sum of both halves it was giving 45, and if we take 81, so sum of two halves would be 8 plus 1, that is a 9. After that, calculate the square of the sum value. Square of sum value, that means sum value is this, square of this, square of this, 9 square. Okay, after that, if the sum value is equal to the original number, then that is your tech number, otherwise that is not your tech number. So let's start see with the help of BlueJ program. So I have already created over here BlueJ program. Let's try to understand this simple scanner class and some variables I have taken here. These are the some integer variables, and here we are asking from the user to enter any number. And what is n and n1? N and n1 we are taking as a backup in variables, because we are going to split cut our number, so we have to take backup of our number. So two times I have taken the backup of our number, that is n and n1. Next is count number of digits. So this is what here we are counting the number of digits. Let's see how it is working. Suppose our number is 2025. So if we divide 2025 by 10, it will give you 202. And it will increment this count variable. And you can see above count variable we have taken, it is equal to 0. So it will increment this variable by 1. So if its value would be 1, next time again it will go here 202 divided by 10. Again it will increment its value by 1. So this is how count variable keep on increasing. So if you have a number 2025, so its value would be 4. Okay. If you have any number 314, so its value would be 3. So this is how count variable will work. And then after that we will see अगर काउंट वेरिएबल पूरा डिवाइड होता है 2 से, दैट मीन्स दैट इज, अगर काउंट वेरिएबल डिवाइड नहीं होता है 2 से, तो दैट इज योर नॉट टेक नंबर. दैट मीन्स सपोज योर काउंट वेरिएबल वैल्यू इज 4, 4 मॉडुलस 2, इट विल गिव यू 0. देन वी विल गो फर्दर, अदरवाइज वी विल प्रिंट that number is not a tech number. If your count variable value is 3, 3 modulus 2, it's not equal to 0. So this condition is correct, then it will give you number is not tech number. Okay, if your count variable is even, then it will come to the else part. So now let's see how first half and last half we are calculating. So first half, how we are calculating? Num divided by math power, this power function, 10 to the power count divided by 2. Suppose your count variable value is 4. So 4 divided by 2 is 2. That means 10 to the power 2 is 100. So num divided by 100 will give you first half. Okay. So let me tell you how it will give. So suppose you have number 2025. So what we have written, 2025 divided by your math power 10 to the power count divided by 2. So count divided by 2 will give you 2. So 10 to the power 2, that is your 2025 divided by 100. So if you do this, it will give you 20. Okay, so this is how we are fetching first half. Now, how we are fetching last half? See here difference, num modulus. Here we are taking modulus and same syntax. Now, let's see over here. This is our number, so 2025 modulus 100. So what it will give you? It will give you 25. Modulus will give you the remainder. So So it will give you 25. That means your last half. So this is how we are fetching first half and last half. So after that, we have to take the sum of first half and last half, and we are storing it in some variable. And at last, we are checking whether our sum is equals to our original number. And what is n1? I told you कि backup बनाने के लिए variable लिया था. तो sum multiply sum, that is your sum square. If it is equals to your original number, then your number is tech number. Otherwise, your number is not a tech number. So this is your program. So let's run this and see how output is coming. Okay. Enter any number. So I have entered 2025. So number is your tech number. Again, 345. So number is your not tech number. So this is how it is working. So thank you for watching the video.